हेलो।
We will start in 2 minutes at exactly 9:15. Prashant, can you hear me? Prashant,
हेलो,
can you hear me?
आई कैन हियर यू मैम। यू कैन हियर मी?
Yeah, and you can see
हेलो,
the screen.
आई कैन सी द स्क्रीन।
ओके ओके
एक्चुअली इट्स नॉट प्रशांत, इट्स मी मैम, डॉक्टर अचिंत। आई डोंट नो व्हाई इट्स शोइंग प्रशांत सर एवरी डे।
नो प्रॉब्लम. यू विल शेयर द पीपीटी नो आफ्टर आई फिनिश
विच
एट नाइन
पीपीटी?
ओ'क्लॉक.
ये विच पीपीटी हैव टू शेयर?
इस पीपीटी ओनली ऑफ ऑस्की
Which one? OSCE actually is in the pen drive. There are four ones.
ऑस्की 4 टेबल 4.
Table 4, season 2. Okay.
मिस्टर राकेश मेक डॉक्टर कौशल को होस्ट. मेक डॉक्टर रंजीत को होस्ट. एंड डॉक्टर कृणाल, ही हैज नॉट जॉइंड येट. Whenever he joins.
ओके मैम।
Okay, we are going to start. All of you can try to answer the questions. Please don't discuss the answers right now in the chat box. This is your first slide. I can't give the history. The first question is how will the patient present? So you have to only write the history in short. Your next slide. Please see carefully. Sorry for the typos. It is, what are the presenting symptoms? What are the presenting symptoms? Age of patient, 60-year-old female. Your next slide. Please see carefully. See the image once more. I can give you history. Patient had sudden excruciating pain after sexual intercourse. This is your next slide. Image again. Image. This is your next slide. Questions. Your next slide is this. There are two images to this question, so please see both properly. I'll flash them again. Patient has history of pain in the left lumbar region. This is a CT scan. This is the DTPA. Questions. Adult, it's an adult age, it's an adult 40-year-old male. Age is 40-year-old male. Your next slide. This is the image again. Thank you. This is your next slide. Patient is a 70-year-old Hindu male who came with hematuria and difficulty in passing urine with difficulty in retracting the foreskin. Creatinine was 2.5. I will show the image once or twice more. This is the image. This is your next image. Okay, so that is it. There were 12 slides. I'll just go through each and every slide once more for y'all. In case if y'all have missed out anything or if anybody has joined late, y'all can still try to answer the questions. So I'm just going to go on from the first slide again. This time I will only flash everything for just 1 minute. Dr. Achint?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, you can share the PPT now because I will be leaving the meeting soon.
Hello.
Yeah, can you share the PPT? Achint?
How am I supposed to share ma'am?
Share screen.
Prashant, you're there, na? Just show Achint.
I'm logging by Prashant's name. He was using
Achint. Achint, wo share content hai na, wo dabao na. Beech mein ek button hai na, share content. Share green screen. Color ka tab hai, dekh beech mein.
This one?
Yes,
correct.
Perfect.
Oh.
Abhi bada screen kar do usko.
Slide show kar de, slide show. Barabar. Yeah.
Hi, Hiren sir. Gaurangsha sir is just joining. Mr. Rakesh, recording ho raha hai?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you so much. Mr. Rakesh, can you unmute iPhone? That is Dr. Gaurangsha. And make him co-host.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah, Gaurangsha sir?
Yeah.
Okay, sir.
Teacher sir has joined?
No, not yet.
Okay.
Hiren sir has joined.
Hiren sir has joined. Teacher sir, ko just give him a message. Okay, yes. To all the students, which are the center you got now?
So how will they answer?
No, they can write down in the share content, na?
Yeah, in the chat box, you can put it.
Yeah, or otherwise, there are four. How many students are answering today?
There are three students.
Sir, me, sir, myself, Dr. Ranjit, sir. Kokila Ben, we have got Kokila Ben, one center in Mumbai, and one in Pune, sir, Dinanath Mangeshkar.
Okay, okay. Achha, and other people, they have got Gangaram, Delhi, and this Kamineni. And Zydus Ahmedabad. Okay, okay. So I think from Mumbai it is Kokila Ben and Pune in Maharashtra and Mumbai.
Yes, sir.
And Ramaya also. Fine. Dr. Jite has joined.
No, I'm just speaking to him.
Yes. Good evening. I have joined.
Oh, great. Okay. Okay. Then we start then?
Yes, sir.
Because Maheshwari told me that he is little busy. He will join little late.
Okay, sir. No problem.
Okay. Fine. Let's go. Tanvi, let's start.
Yes, sir. So I'll be taking your leave. Thank you so much.
Hiren Soda sir ko ye kar do.
Hiren Soda sir joined there.
Yes sir, I am there sir. Good evening sir.
Good evening.
Yeah.
Sir, I'll be taking your leave. Sorry.
Okay, when who is
Thank you Tanvi. Sir, Achint is there sir. Achint.
I am sharing screen sir. Achint.
I have written the names of the students who are answering. So Dr. Ranjit to be unmuted first.
He is unmuted.
Yes, sir. I'm here.
Yeah. Okay. Let's start. Okay, Achin, questions.
Sir, this is the case of clot retention, sir. The patient will present as hematuria followed by suprapubic pain and inability to pass urine, sir. Patient may also present with flank pain or a lower tract symptom, sir, if there is infective cause. Enumerate the conditions in which it occurs. Now, it can be due to malignancy, either carcinoma of bladder, upper tract TCC, or renal cell carcinoma. It can also occur in stone diseases, in case of trauma, or any post-instrumentation, post-procedure, or if the in case of coagulopathy, sir, if it's, clotting factors are deranged, and other rare causes can be acute phase of genitourinary tuberculosis, or cystitis like radiation cystitis or hemorrhagic cystitis. Important investigation to be done, sir. First, I would like routine investigation in the form of CBC, electrolyte, creat, PTINR of the patient, blood grouping and cross-matching, and ultrasound KUB, sir.
Yeah, go ahead. Fine, you are doing well.
Different ways to remove it, sir. First, as the patient will be in the retention, I'll put a 22 French three-way catheter and empty as much urine as possible if it is present, and then give a bladder wash, sir. Bladder wash till I get a till I get clear urine of around clear input and output for about 1 liter, sir. In between, I will also change the position of the catheter and twist it so that the eye faces to different quadrants. And if it is not able to empty completely, then I would like an emergency cystoscopy and clot evacuation of this patient after I have taken care of his after he is resuscitated and stabilized.
Okay, so now final different ways of remove it. See, you have to just enumerate. One is that you'll put the which size Foley's catheter. That is most important. So you will put
3 sir.
Yeah. Second thing is. Yeah. Second thing is by cystoscopy. Now, if there is a big clot, then how will you remove? With which instruments you will use?
Sir, I will use Tumi syringe, sir.
But which sheath you will use?
Sir, a maximum diameter of 25 French, sir. 25 French sheath, and I'll suck it with a Tumi syringe, sir.
Sir has given you a hint that it's a large clot. You may require something to break it.
Just see the specimen and think how that was removed.
Chips.
It looks like a chip. It clot.
Sir, we can introduce a resectoscope, sir, and then.
Correct. That is what sir wanted to know. So you should get the hint of the examiner, okay?
Yes, sir.
So important thing is that you will, if you have attended 2-3 clot retention, you'll realize that you have to put not only a 25 French sheet. Yes, that's a one of the alternative. But the best thing is to use the resectoscope, right? That sheet.
Yes,
and one is a Tumi syringe. Second thing is sometimes the clot may not come out. You might have to take it out like bits. So what you have to do is that you might have to use a resectoscope. You might have to use a suction also. So all different ways. Okay, so these are the different ways to remove it. You have to just enumerate all these things. An important thing is which size of catheter and which size of sheath you are going to use. That will carry marks.
Yes.
Okay. Gita sir, you want to add any question or anything here you want to add?
No, sir. No, it's going well.
Okay, fine. Okay, then next slide.
So, describe and give DDs of the lesion. So, this is a reddish exophytic mass, which is at the lower part of the urethral meatus. I would like to give a DD as first will be a urethral caruncle, or it can be a urethral mucosal prolapse, or it can be a skin gland cyst, or it can be a leiomyoma, or it can be a cyst in the vaginal wall. It can also be a urethral diverticulum, sir. Then how will the patient present? Patient will present with spotting or pain at the area, at the lesion, or she can also present with voiding symptoms like poor flow, straining, and intermittency. How will you manage this case, sir? If the lesion is small, then we can try a conservative treatment in the form of either local estrogen therapies, NSAIDs, and SIDS bath. If it is large and it is not amenable to conservative treatment, we can do a simple excision of the caruncle.
But the management should always be treatment, investigations, and treatment.
Yes.
So you must say that I will investigate and then I will treat.
I will treat, yes.
So important investigation you have to say. One is a sonography and second is a cystoscopy. Someone has already mentioned. So you will always do a cystoscopy also.
Why sir is telling only these two? Because it's OSCE. You don't have to start telling everything, urine routine, this, that, blah, blah, blah. Be specific.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Gita, sir, you want to ask any questions?
Yes, yes. In spite of asking, I may have to add something to him. After seeing this picture, there is a donut-like mass protruding from the meatus of the female urethra. And usually, it is the most common differential diagnosis is either mucosal prolapse or carbuncle.
Carbuncle.
On clinical examination, how will you differentiate between two? That question may be inside that OSCE. So you should know that all circumferentially there is mucosal prolapse, and usually on the posterior wall it is a caruncle.
Okay.
And differential diagnosis of mucosal prolapse. One of the differential diagnosis you told it is urethral diverticulum.
how urethral diverticulum come outside the urethral mat.
Sir, a circumferential might come distal circumferential.
That's what. If it is a diverticulum, it will go in one. It is from one of the part of the urethra, and it is going in that surrounding tissue. It will not come through the mucosa. It will not come through the opening of the urethra. That's what I want to say. And the common differential diagnosis, it can be ureteroscopic, prolapsing ureteroscopic. It can be a leiomyoma of the distal ureter. It can be a urethral malignancy. It can be a condyloma. It can be a rhabdomyosarcoma. It can. So these are the differential diagnosis that you should tell in exam.
And the order which Gitesh sir has told is very important. From common most to the rare most.
Yes. So operations, treatment, they may ask. One of the questions is medical treatment or surgical treatment. You know about this treatment. One liner, two liner treatment, pata rehna chahiye. Nahi to end time ko problem ho sakta hai. You may get into the trouble. These are some additions for mass prolapsing from the urethra. Okay.
Yeah.
We can go ahead, sir.
Yeah. This is the next slide.
So describe the picture and give diagnosis. It is a picture showing the genital areas. There is ecchymosis of the penis and scrotum area with swelling over the penile shaft, and there is a deviation of the penis, sir. So most likely a case of penile fracture, sir. How will the patient present? Patient will present to us following trauma while having sexual intercourse. There might be sudden popping or cracking or sound followed by sudden deutuminescence and swelling over the scrotum and deviation. If there is associated urethral injury, patient may present with blood at the meatus. How will you investigate? Apart from routine investigation, I would also like to have an ultrasound of the local ultrasound of penis to see the exact site of the this penile fracture. If it is equivocal, I would like an MRI of the penis. And after fixed diagnosis, or if in case of a suspected urethral injury, I would like a retrograde urethrogram of the patient. And angiography. And angiography to document the erection post this trauma. How will you manage? This looks like a case of rupture in the tunica. I would like to go ahead with a surgical treatment in this case. If there was no rupture of the tunica, we could have conserved it with NACI cold compression. In this case, we would like to do a surgical management in the case in like exploration by taking a circumferential incision and degloving, then finding the tunical, evacuating or removing the hematoma, then finding the defect, and then suturing the defect with either 20 or 320 PDS or paliglectin sutures, and then close.
Yeah. So there are two things. One is the MRI and second is the RGU. Is there any role of RGU or MRI?
Sir, if so you will do it.
If you are suspecting rupture urethra, then you will do it.
Yes, sir. If there is blood in meatus during examination, sir.
History, clinical examination, and plus minus reflex ultrasound of the penis, usually will suffice for the diagnosis.
Yes.
Okay. So,
yes.
Role of special investigations like MRI is usually required for to detect a small defect. One, a retrograde urethrogram is usually advised when there is a blood at the meatus or there is a urethroregia. Okay. So, red color or some discharge. And it is 20% of the cases of fracture penis is associated with the urethral injury. Why urgent surgical treatment is mandatory. What happens if you are treated conservatively? It will end up into either a plaque. Initially, it is a fibrous, later on, calcified plaque, erectile dysfunction, angulation, that is curvature, painful erection, and infection of the hematoma. When there is a Buck's passage intact, then only the classical deformity, eggplant deformity, will be seen in the clinical examination. When Buck's passage is ruptured, then there is no thing like a clinical eggplant deformity on clinical examination. Treatment localized incision over the hematoma, that is control, that can be done. Few centers will do like that, by marking the incision with the Doppler duplex ultrasound, and conventionally circumcoronal incision and degluing right up to the defect and closure of the defect. That is the two ways of doing the repair of the defect due to the plaque. And commonly used things, material is 203040 Vicryl as per the usual routine departmental protocol. That's all.
Yes, the most important is the timing of repair. It should be done within few hours, ideally. And that is why you may not do all the investigations also, except that, you know, routine blood investigation and take the patient. That is number one. But there are paper also which shows that even the delayed repair is useful. So there are paper which shows that even after 2 weeks or 3 weeks, repair has been done and the results are good.
Yes, sir. Mera khud ka hi paper hai ki fracture pain is not so rare in India. So early repair is usually having a good results. That is within within few hours, so 4 hours, 6 hours. So usually it is described as 6 to 8 hours. But there are a number of papers which will show okay, the results is good up to 2 weeks or 3 weeks. I have paper, both are paper. And stitches, someone is asking stitches how to repair the defect. We usually repair the defect with the Vicryl 20 as per the length of the defect, and as it is got resolved in the 90 days. Some people will use purulin also. That is also reported, but we are not using other future material than the Vicryl. In chat box, someone has asked indication for MRI. I already told when there is a clinical suspicion of fracture and ultrasound oblique clinical examination doesn't show any defect in the tunica albuginea of the corpora, in suspicion there is a role of MRI. Otherwise, primarily MRI is not.
Yeah, someone has asked about the inserted, not inside.
Doesn't matter if you take not.
Doesn't matter actually, because we are, yeah, it is going to get absorbed. And so if the knot is inside, then it may not get absorbed very nicely. So I think we take not, the knots outside only.
Not inside and not outside concept was recently described by Jagdish Kulkarni sir in doing the urethroplasty, and he felt if it is outside, it will form a fibrosis and various fibrosis and again recurrent structure. So he will place the knot inside. That's what his concept is. But as far as fracture pain is concerned, it doesn't matter. Someone is raising the hand. Europe is, if he want to tell anything, he can make. Usko ye kar do sir.
अनम्यूट करो एक मिनट में ले
यूरोप पे जी कौन है उसको अनम्यूट करो इफ यू वांट टू टेल देम यू वांट टू आस्क और टेल अनम्यूट ओके
ही कैन जस्ट राइट डाउन यू कैन इंस्टेड ऑफ रेजिंग योर हैंड यू कैन जस्ट राइट डाउन
ओके
Okay, no problem. Let's go ahead. Yeah, Kaushal is answering.
Okay, next. Kaushal.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Where is the center?
GMC Trivandrum, sir. Kerala.
Okay. Fine. So you've seen the figure,
yes,
no?
Sir. No? Yes, sir. Yeah. Sir, seeing the image, it appears a hydrocele, sir.
Right.
See properly, beta. Diagnosis. We are not layman.
It is a clinical test. Someone is demonstrating. What demonstrating someone is? Okay, phone dekh raha hai mujhe wahan pe.
See, clinical diagnosis is tunica vaginalis hydrocele. Yeah. Just say like that.
Okay.
No, sir. Huh? I am not agree with his diagnosis, because how he knows that there is a hydrocele? It is a just,
yeah.
it is a just demonstration of transillumination.
Yes.
So what are the indication of doing transillumination test? What are the things are transilluminate? What are the things are not transilluminate? These questions are going to
happen. Sir, yes, sir.
Kaushal, go ahead.
Clinical test to confirm it is, sir, transillumination test to get above the swelling and absence of cough impulse.
And? Fluctuation test.
Fluctuation test, yes, sir. Fluctuation test.
Okay. In which conditions those tests will be negative? So mainly trans illumination and whatever it is. And the fluctuation.
MS ka question hai. MS question. Patapat answer chahiye.
Yes, sir. This condition in hydrocele, sir, you are asking this condition in negative in hydrocele or other conditions?
Just answer in which conditions.
In which conditions those tests will be negative?
Both the tests will be negative.
Called hydrocele or infected hydrocele, this test will be negative.
Simply think it when fluid is transferred. When
yes,
fluid
sir.
Is without any contamination.
Yes, sir.
Hydrocele for third case of it. इन्फेक्टेड हाइड्रोसील हेमाटोसील पायोसील उसके बाद में क्या वो स्पर्मेटोसील ये सब चीजों में कैसे दिखेगा नहीं थिक स्किन थिक ब्लैक स्किन अगर
टेस्ट इज नॉट डन प्रॉपर्ली दैट टाइम आल्सो मींस इफ टॉर्च इज नॉट केप्ट इन टॉर्च इज केप्ट इन फ्रंट ऑफ टेस्टिस
ये सब चीजें फटाफट आ जाना चाहिए सिंपल टेस्ट इसमें कोई कंफ्यूजन नहीं इसमें कंफ्यूजन होगा तो सिंपल मार्क चला जाएगा
यस सर.
So you can go from outside, thickened skin, thickened sac, calcified sac, then lymphangiocele, like pyocele, hematocele, like all very large testes. And then as you are saying, the test is not done properly.
And most importantly, tumor also. Include tumor.
Yes, and the tumor.
Yes,
fine?
Sir. Yes.
Okay. Enumerate different surgeries.
Jabul is eversion of the sac and not plication.
Indication for Jabul is an indication for lot of plaquage.
Jabul's repair is done for large hydrocele and large plaquation can be done for small size sac.
Okay. Fine. Anything else, Hiran, you want to ask? Akshay Nathani has asked.
No, sir, he is doing well.
Akshay, what is your question? For the pediatric age group. Okay, go ahead. Next.
He is asking about the incidence of secondary hydrocele.
Huh.
Okay. Oh, sir.
Yes, sir. 10.
Secondary hydrocele.
Jewel has answered it. 10%.
10%, yes, sir.
Okay, we'll go ahead.
Yes, sir. Sir, this questions identify the apparatus. So this is the three-piece inflatable penile implant. What are the parts? It has three parts, sir. Two cylinders, then pump and reservoir.
And the connecting tubes.
Okay, connecting tubes, sir. Enumerate the types. It is two types, sir. Semi-rigid and inflatable. Semi-rigid is having two types again. malleable and positional, and inflatable is 2-piece and 3-piece device.
Okay.
And what are the complications? Complications are most common is the infection. Then second is device malfunction. Third is perforation and erosion of the device.
And the last one. What is a drooping flower? See, if it is not reaching right up to the glands, penis.
Yes, sir. Buckling.
Up to the glands, then that glands will be like a drooping flower.
Okay, sir.
Huh? It will remain soft.
Okay, sir.
Fine. Okay. And I don't think there anything, because now 6 marks only are there. So they will usually ask, you know, all these questions only in 6 marks. Go ahead. I'll just tell you that another slide is not there where the rhinogram is done and DTPA scan is, yeah, this is a DTPA scan. Okay. Fine. Go ahead. Questions?
Diagnosis, sir. This patient is presented with left lumbar pain. There is a CT showing there is a gross hydronephrosis on the left side with a abrupt tapering at the pelvis. So my diagnosis is left PU jaw obstruction, sir.
Have you seen the rhinogram?
Graph dekho, partial.
Yes, sir.
DTPA scan. Achin, just show him the DTPA scan. No.
See carefully and then come. See graph, see delayed images. Zoom it and see the what is the conclusion there written. Everything is in front of you. Take 1 minute and answer.
Can you see the graph, green and red, both? Okay, now can you answer? Kaushal?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yes. So three people have answered and all three are right. There is a delayed drainage, but it is emptying. Okay.
Okay.
Now it's question. Achin. See, sometimes you get such patients in your clinic. There is no absolute PU junction obstruction.
Would you want to know some specific value from the rhinogram to decide whether it's obstructed or not?
But T half is normal on both sides.
So that is also important.
Function is also normal on both sides.
Right.
Yes.
T half, you should see diuretic T half.
He is a symptomatic, so I think need surgery.
So what do you suspect then? What do you suspect? What is happening here?
Partial obstruction, maybe.
Yeah, so what is that called?
Intermittent latent crisis.
Correct.
CT picture dikhao ek bar.
So what is the cause?
In that case, what is the cause? Specific rhinogram. In case of
any impression at PU junction, some feeling defect.
Yes, sir. Feeling defect is there.
So it is because of what?
Crossing vessel. Yeah. No, no.
Yes, sir. It can be because of crossing vessel.
Crossing vessel. Correct. So basically, this patient has got mild hydronephrosis, correct? But the drainage is complete. And maybe a partial obstruction secondary to?
Aberrant vessel or lower polar vessel.
Okay. So that is your first diagnosis. Now, what is the second question?
How will you counsel the patient?
Yeah. How will you counsel the patient? You want to operate this patient?
Yes, sir. As he is symptomatic patient, I will explain him that it is a congenital anomaly. It needs correction to prevent further deterioration and complications of a renal function. It may or may not improve the existing function, but it can prevent further damage. So he needs intervention.
Anything else, sir, has showed you a filling defect. So yes, would you sir, like that, to counsel him for that?
Yes, sir. There is a lower polar vessel. Vessel is there. So,
maybe.
No.
Maybe,
no,
yes, we sir. Have not done arteriogram. No,
yes, arteriogram is needed. Yes, sir. Angiogram is needed to confirm that.
You will try to preserve it, but there is a every chance that it can get damaged. So you need to counsel regarding that.
Okay, sir.
And also, if you're suspecting Dietl's crisis, any specific type of renogram would you like to do? Go ahead. Why you're not confident? You said
diuretic
it.
Diuretic renogram, yes, sir.
So F minus 15 will load. Correct. But it's done, but you have to be able to answer. No?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
So if there is a proper drainage and he is draining everything, then why you want to operate?
He is having intermittent pain, sir. Sometimes it can cause complete obstruction and cause further damage to his renal function and complications can occur.
What is the age of the patient?
It is, I think, 40 years around, sir. They have not mentioned age, but Tanvi madam told it's 40 years.
40.
Yes, sir. 40.
So till 40 years, is both function is maintained.
Yes, sir.
No deterioration, no gross difference between two sided function.
Yes, sir.
Okay, but yes, clinically sir. Symptomatic. I will tell you, few people will not agree with the concept of partial fuse. Fuse hai, fuse nahi hai. Fuse is there or fuse is not there. There is nothing like a partial fuse.
Correct.
Just to add to what Gita sir is telling you, that he is symptomatic, and if you look at the CT images, there is a loss of calcial cupping, plus there is hydronephrosis and
parenchymal thinning there, yes sir.
Yeah.
Compared to right side, there is left side parenchymal thin and upper and lower pole.
Correct. So CT is also important. So when you correlate everything, patient symptoms, parenchyma, look at the anatomy of the pelvic alveolar system compared to right side and diuretic renogram. Of course, renogram is normal, but when you load it, maybe there could be an obstruction demonstrated. Also, sometimes they say that it is good to do the renogram when there is episode of pain.
Yeah. See, first of all, we are not sure whether there is a crossing vessel or not. So for that, you have to do angiography, number one. So number two, you know, the thing is that some, as Dr. Gita said, either there is obstruction or there is no obstruction. Now, you can see that the graph is showing that there is a total emptying, little bit, that it is delayed, but it is totally emptying. So whether you, by doing the surgery, whether you will justify or not, that is also important. So some people may say that, okay, I will not operate you, but I will keep you under observation and I will do the regular study. So that is the next question. What is the next question?
How will you manage this patient?
Yeah. So how will you counsel this patient? You will counsel this patient in both the ways. That there may be a crossing vessel, you will like to do angiography. And if your pain is very severe, okay, even if their function is good and there is a total drainage, I will like to operate it and I will put the PU junction in front of the vessel. That is number one. Or you can say that I will not like to operate, but I will follow up you. And if you are deteriorating, in that case, or if you have got a severe pain, I will operate you. So how will you manage this patient?
Yes, sir. I will do some CT angiogram for confirming the aberrant vessel and the lower pole. Then I will do routine investigation, CBC, RFK, and urine culture and urine examination. And I will tell he needs surgical intervention. And I will do Anderson Sahens pyeloplasty.
That is one aspect. But yes, suppose if he doesn't have much pain.
Yes, if he's not willing for surgery,
and he's already 40 years old and already there is not, both the kidneys are showing a good function.
Yes,
what is the second alternative?
We can keep him on active surveillance observation.
We can repeat the test
after 6 months. Yeah.
So which test you will do? How will you follow?
We'll do all tests are there, sir. We'll just do the clinical assessment, sir.
What is the clinical assessment?
If he's asymptomatic, sir, we can observe him further. If he's getting again pain and infection episodes, then we need to intervene.
So you will like to do sonography and see whether the hydro in the same place, same person should do sonography to find out whether there is any increase in the size of the pelvis as well as the hydronephrosis, number one, and the parenchymal thinning. And in that case, again, you will like to do renogram to see the deterioration of the function. And then if it is deteriorating, you'll go ahead with the surgery.
Okay.
Okay, so you have to counsel him in both the ways.
Okay.
Fine. Yes. Whittaker test, we are not... Okay. Gita sir, I think that's okay.
Yeah, someone has asked any role of RGP. Yes, there is a role of RGP in equivocal cases. When your clinical suspicion is more towards the obstruction, and just for confirmation of obstruction, I and majority people will usually place to do a cystoscopy, do RGP, confirm the obstruction, and we usually place guide wire also across the QJ, or if it's not going, it just tell to the QJ.
I will add only one thing. I don't know whether it is routinely done or not, but whenever I am in doubt, I put a DJ stent and see if the patient improves his symptomatologically. That means he has got a problem. And after removal of the DJ stent, again the pain appears. Then according to me, that is the indication for surgery in these cases. But this is... practical. I am not talking about theoretical.
Yeah, olden days, this is the only test usually people will do when the things are not available in terms of investigation. But nowadays, sir, at the most, addition of RGP with available investigation will suffice. And role of digestenting in diagnosis of PUJ is the people usually not.
Yeah.
Right. But practically, okay. You are right. That is the confirmatory test.
Correct. That is only the practical point I'm giving.
Yes.
Okay. Sir. Next. Yeah, Krunal.
Yes, sir. Sir, in the X-ray, it's showing a teen lead that is used for the sacral neuromodulation. That is the third mark is beyond the sacral S3 foramina. That is the correct location for lead. What are the indications, sir? Indications are refractory overactive bladder, both neurogenic and idiopathic. Spinal cord injury, that is a detrusor excess sphincter dyssynergia, then Hinman syndrome, Fowler syndrome, chronic pelvic pain syndrome. Even it can be used in bowel bladder dysfunction also. Alternatives or treatment option will be the intravesical electrical stimulation, then transcutaneous electrical nerve stimulation, that include all peripheral nerve, like pudendal nerve, tibial nerve, posterior tibial nerve, or it could be the anterior sacral root stimulation with the total sacral rhizotomy.
Which are the alternative treatments? So apart from that, what else?
Sir, regarding the overactive bladder or
anything? Now you told about the indications.
Alternative treatment means alternative to this procedure. Indication is same. That you are told.
But sir, we can use this CIC, continuous intermittent catheterization. We can use anticholinergic. We can use even intravesical botulinum injection also. And if everything fails, we can do the augmentation cystoplasty.
Fine. Achha, just show the picture again. Some people wanted to see. Okay. Fine. I think you have indication. Someone has asked about interstitial cystitis.
Yes, sir. A chronic pelvic plane syndrome, I said this. Okay. Interstitial cystitis, it can be used in chronic orchalgia also, sir.
Okay.
Recently, they have added that.
Oh, fine. Great. I think you have covered everything. So, yes, this is only thing is because, you know, these are the things which may come because they will, every time they will not have, they may not like to put the same slides again and again. Otherwise, we have done all the OSCE and earlier OSCE, you please go through. We have got urodynamic study. We have done microscopic the pathology slides also in OSCE, and we have done the specimens also and instruments. So we are not repeating the same thing. So we are putting something new. Okay, next, Achin. See it very carefully, yeah?
Yes, sir.
So the history is 70 years old Hindu male, specifically Hindu male, came with hematuria and difficulty in passing urine, with difficulty in retracting foreskin, and his creatinine is 2.5.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Questions? Yeah.
There is a right side ectopic kidney with a left upper polar renal mass. And
see again.
How many kidneys are there?
The three are there, sir.
Then?
So three kyun rahenge? Kab rahenge three?
Supernumeric kidney.
Are you a common thing? Bolo na. Transplant.
Okay.
So what is there in the right kidney?
It is transplanted kidney, sir.
No, right kidney. What is there in the right kidney?
So that is a polycystic. Multiple cysts are there.
So big cyst is there. Okay. What about
acquired renal cystic cases?
Then the left-sided?
Left-sided mass is there, upper polar mass. So the diagnosis will be...
And the transplant kidney?
Kidney, yes, sir.
And see in the bladder. What do you see in the bladder?
Stone is there, sir. One stone is there.
No, just see properly better. What is the history? Patient had hematuria and difficulty in passing urine. So what you are suspecting?
First row, last slide.
Clot.
Exactly.
Clot.
Yes.
And you can't see in this film, but I think there is a, even the enlarged, if you see properly, there is an enlarged prostate also. Anyway, okay, but I think these four things so you must say because it is very clearly seen.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yeah. You are doing very well, but don't be in a hurry to answer. Take your time to see the X-ray properly or CT properly.
Yes, sir. So, sir, in this, sir, diagnosis will be like end-stage renal disease with acquired renal cystic disease with left renal mass with transplanted kidney and blood clot in in the bladder.
Fine. Okay. So, how will you manage this patient?
Sir, I'll do the routine investigation necessary for RCC, like liver function test, ESR, calcium, and as well as I will do DRE and serum PSA. I'll do urinary and cytology as hematuria is there. As prostate side will be mentioned in the CT report. So according to that, I will manage, sir. As it is having a difficulty in retracting foreskin also, so he might have fibrosis also. So my plan of treatment will be circumcision with left side nephrectomy, radical nephrectomy. Beta, what we'll do first, patient has got difficulty in passing urine and he has got hematuria. He has come in emergency.
Yes, sir.
What you are suspecting? And you are seeing the clot inside.
Clot retention, sir.
So first you'll do circumcision with clot evacuation.
Clot evacuation, sir.
And from where this clot has come?
From, sir, the left side, sir.
Are you 100% sure?
Sir, RCC from RCC, sir.
What else it can be?
Circumcision, cystoscopy, confirmation of the site of hematuria, clot evacuation, and proceed.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. It could be BPH also, sir. Prostate.
Exactly. Yes, in this patient, he had a BPH. So we had to do, there was a little bleeding from the surface. So yes, we sir. Did TURP also. And then next stage, we did the nephrectomy.
Okay, sir. Fine.
Okay. But you can say clot evacuation, circumcision. Circumcision is mandatory because yes. He is transplanted kidney. So,
yes,
prevent the infection. Okay, because he is going to be on immunosuppression.
Yes,
right?
Sir. Yes,
so,
sir.
Like in children, when there is a neurogenic bladder.
Yes,
sir. Or, you know, so we do the circumcision the same way. The third question. Yes.
Regarding counseling, sir, I will explain patient with sympathy and empathy that I'll explain about the diagnosis as he's having a left renal mass, which is commonly seen in acquired cystic lesion disease. He may require radical nephrectomy. And I will explain about the post-op complications as well as prognosis. And as his creatinine is also increasing, I will do nephrology consultation. I will explain regarding follow-up for the nephrectomy, sir.
But are you not counseling regarding the clot evacuation?
Yes, sir.
What
I'll, sir, I will tell the first in first stage I will planning to do the clot evacuation proceed like in this prostatomegaly is there I will do the resection if urine is just infection free. Otherwise I'll do just clot evacuation and once the infection subside I will do the TURP and the further management, sir.
So how will you counsel? I think you should counsel the patient saying that he has got difficulty in retracting skin and he has got a transplant kidney. So he is requires a circumcision also. At the same time, you'll do the clot evacuation and you'll assess the prostate. If needed, you can always do it in the second stage or at the same time, number one. And yes. Later on, you will also, as soon as possible, you like to do the nephrectomy. Why nephrectomy and why not partial nephrectomy?
There is actually kidney is a end stage renal disease, sir. So there is no meaning of doing the nephron sparing surgery.
Yeah. Can you unmute Akshay Nathani? Just unmute Akshay Nathani, no? Okay, fine. So it's an end stage renal disease. So there is no need of doing partial nephrectomy.
Yes, sir.
Fine. Okay. Hiren, you want to add anything?
No, sir. Only thing is that He's answering well, but little bit of attention towards the CT scan, going slow, meticulous, and paying attention to the history. Because two or three times we told him hematuria is there. So you have to keep that in mind. What is the patient presented with? Don't start treating something else.
Yeah. Okay, sir. Yes, yeah. Sir. Thank you.
Fine. Okay. Next, Achin. Okay.
Sir, this is a procedure of supine PCNL. Sir, actually, it's not
please,
a universal.
No. Tell us full diagnosis, full procedure.
Sir, it's a supine percutaneous nephrolithotomy.
No, but which one? It is a regular or it is a mini?
No, sir, it is mini perk, sir, because the universal scope is that is a small scope.
So then you must say, nah, see again. See?
Yes, sir.
That is why I have kept both the slides. Nah?
Yes, sir.
See, it will carry 2 marks. If you don't say mini perk, then you lose 1 mark.
Yes,
fine.
Sir.
Okay, second question.
So relative contraindication will be the coagulopathy, infection, and pregnancy will be the relative contraindication.
Beta, first, in this, we are talking about supine PCNL.
The supine PCNL also, sir, coagulopathy will be the
relative. What is the most problematic part of supine PCNL? What happens?
The kidney will be more mobile.
What injury occurs maximum in supine PCNL?
You are afraid why people are not doing supine PCNL so often?
The colonic injury.
Exactly. Intestinal and colonic injury are the most common. Means, if you go to see the percentage wise, it
yes,
will
sir.
Be seen in supine PCNL. No?
Yes, sir.
So, in which condition you will not like to do?
Sir. Retrorenal colon.
One, yes. On CT scan, if you are seeing the gas behind the second thing.
There are stone in the posterior calyx as we are mostly targeting anterior calyx and supine PCNL.
That's okay. Be out and stag on also. That's not a problem.
So then upper calyx?
Yes, if it is going very high, then it becomes very difficult. Okay, that is another relative.
Then, sir, horseshoe kidney.
Even the horseshoe kidney public has done, but mal-rotated kidney, yes.
Mal-rotated, yes.
Yes. And?
The pelvic will be supine. Yeah.
Someone has already written, severely morbid obese patient. Why?
Is already in the supine patient track will be long.
Long, correct.
So, in fine. The obese patient, require more time.
It will be difficult. Your ampullar sheet may go inside only, or you may require a large sheet. What is the size of the normal sheet?
So length or
length.
Length, 16 centimeters.
So, you require 20 centimeters because these scopes are 22 centimeters.
Yes.
You know? So,
yes,
that is why. Okay. And another contraindication is when the patient is already has undergone open surgery and there is a hernia. So after open surgery, na, again, there will be a mal position of the intestine or of the colon.
Colon. Okay.
So that is another relative contraindication.
Okay, sir.
So somebody is asking question, is supine better in obese patients? Double question mark.
The track becomes sometimes very long because the fat is falling down. Na? While you are going in a prone, you know, you can select the distance. Okay,
somebody
next
has asked the question that is supine better in obese patients. I want you to answer that question.
By answer karo usko. Please answer that question.
Sir,
what is your answer?
Sir, in obese patient, conventional PCNM means prone position will be the better because we have the instrument in the prone conventional method. We have the long instrument on that is available.
Okay, so what are the people presenting papers on supine PCNL? What are they claiming? Why is it difficult in an obese patient? What is the difficulty in an obese patient? Difficulty is giving positioning and anesthesia. So they are saying that due to obesity, anesthesia is a challenge because it is compressing the diaphragm. So they are saying in an obese patient, it's easier to keep the supine and using ultrasound, you can have supine advantage over prone position. So you must read some of these papers.
Yeah, my first case, which I did it in 2002. Okay, I did it because that patient, we could not give general anesthesia. And yes, in spinal anesthesia, we could not give him in a prone position because he became breathless because of the pressure on the tummy. That female was too obese. And then suddenly we decided, let us put her in a supine position and try. Because I had read that time there was someone in Egypt was doing a supine PCNL and no one else was doing. So that was the first case, as Dr. Hiren Chhoda is mentioning, that in obese patient, supine PCNL is is a boon if you go to see. The only problem is that you should have that long sheath with you.
Yes, sir.
Correct, sir.
One more question, sir. I have that read the article of
literature wise supine PCNL versus prone PCNL as far as complication and stone free rate is concerned, both are equal.
Yes.
Both have their own indication in some particular suggestion. N number of literature currently suggests to supine PCNL, their colonic injury may not be more.
There are some people are doing only supine.
Whatever both the teachers were telling is that highly morbidly obese patient keeping a prone position, cardiorespiratory reimbursement, maintaining the tube, this is difficult. So that is a class indication for supine. Yes, it is in morbidly obese, this supine will be better for us. But complication and stone free rate, success of the procedure, it is depend upon what I feel and majority literature also support, it is depend upon the surgeon's at present.
Correct.
Fine. Okay, name all the instruments and accessories used in the procedure.
Sir, do we need to write this obesity in the relative contraindication?
See, some people, I will tell you, if you are able to give general anesthesia, then it is always better to do prone position. So that is why the question is relative. It is a relative contraindication.
Okay, sir. And sir, one more question.
Yeah.
Yeah, sir. I have read one article of Guido Gastil, sir. Actually, in that, he is mentioning that this colonic injury is less in supine position compared to conventional PC.
Whatever you are telling, I told you.
Yes, sir.
Then Dr. Guido Vesti is doing only supine PCNLs.
Yes, sir.
And he is doing it right from the beginning. So, like Dr. Gita said, it is also experience of the surgeon, what you are used to.
Okay, sir.
So, there are several series all over the world where people are doing only supine PCNL. And they have reported less colonic injuries.
Okay.
If you see, the world's largest data was collected by Cruz office, is Clinical Research Office of Endourology Society. Largest data of PCNL came from only one country, that is India.
Okay.
So if you see in Europe, they have large complications of bleeding and they are preventing bleeding by using balloons. And they are saying bleeding is more with Alkan's dilators. But in India, we are using Alkan dilators. Every second hospital, even in the small lane in your town, they will be using Alkan dilator. And yes, we are not seeing bleeding so much with Alkan dilators. So that is how you understand it, that what you are used to, you are doing the best.
Yes.
So think global, eat local.
Okay.
Yeah. Name all the instruments and accessories used in the procedure.
Sir, 18 gauge access needle, then guide wire, then mini puck dilator along with sheath, then nephroscope, irrigation tube, camera, light source, then lithotripter, and last thing to retrieve the stone, any grasper, tri-prone grasper or alligator forceps.
Sir, I told you right in the beginning what was the size of the instrument. Then you are saying lithotripter. You should say laser machine.
Yes, sir.
Keep your presence of mind in the exam. Okay?
Yes, sir.
And you like to do cystoscopy. See, last time also we had discussed. Even a cystoscopy is very important. No? Without cystoscopy...
What you are doing in theater, Gita sir keeps telling you, no? What you are doing, how you will do the procedure, you have to tell.
Yes, sir.
You have to start with a cystoscopy. No?
Cystoscopy,
urinary catheter, irrigation, everything. Like, you know, from the beginning. So think that way. That you are going to do the first cystoscopy and then you are going to do PCNL. So that is why the question is, name all the instruments and accessories used in the procedure.
Yes, sir.
Huh?
Yes, don't
if you are running short of time, at least you mentioned cystoscopy set, PCNL set, accessories, video camera, trolley, laser, basket, you know, things like that.
Yes, sir.
Everything. Yeah.
Very good.
Now, yes. Can you tell advantages and disadvantages of this position over conventional position?
Sir, advantage will be the good ergonomic of the surgeon, as this will be done in the sitting position by surgeon. There's a less radiation exposure. There's a less intra-op anesthetic complication. This is actually the gravitation, due to gravitational irrigation, stone clearance is good. Operative time will be the less, will be less, as we don't need to change the position, and we can assess from also. So endoscopic intrarenal surgery is also endoscopic combined intrarenal surgery is also possible with this position. And sir,
so you mentioned ECIRS. What is the position used in ECIRS? Can you name it?
Modified by so Valdivia Uriya, that is
very good. Valdivia Uriya position,
yes, sir.
Yeah,
even Galatgaon, Valdivia Uriya position, that's what it is. Yes,
yes, sir.
Very good.
Sir, and disadvantage, sir, there will be low pressure in the pelvis, as this is a gravitational, this irrigation will come outside. So it may require the pressure. Then this puncture area will be limited. And the most common this disadvantage is mobility of kidney will be high longer track.
When you're doing ECIRS, what is the puncture called? So you have put in a flexible ureteroscope from below. Now you are going to puncture. It is called endoscopic guided
guidance. Yes. You are
looking with the endoscope and you are seeing the needle coming in.
Yes, sir.
Very good.
Yeah. Good. You are answered quite nicely and neatly. Good. Yes. Achin, what is the next one? Okay, I think it is done.
Good evening, sir. Akshay, sir.
Bol Akshay.
OSCE station, that transplant. So just I wanted to add about the counseling of the patient. He transplanted patient and his creatinine is 2.5. So prior to that, just make a flow chart. You write down a history arrow, how much time has been elapsed from transplant. How is the status of drugs actually? You told about the nephrology consultation, but you mentioned about what drugs he's taking. He's on long-term steroid. So actually, if I remember, if this patient is post, I think 10, 12 years transplant, he's on prednisone.
Steroid, 25 years, 25
you
years.
To counsel is accordingly for post-operative wound infection also. That is very important, I think. That should be added.
Okay. Yeah. Because he's on steroid. Correct. fine. Good. I think all of you are very well prepared and you are answering very well. Yes, Gita sir, what do you think?
Sir, it's overall good, but my simple suggestion to all exam going students, keep it very simple, limited.
Point
tell
wise.
Whatever you know, whatever you have seen, whatever you have assisted. This is a practical exam. Person sitting in front of you, not interested in molecular urology, not interested in some high-end urology. Majority examiners are interested in basic urology. And majority examiner is want to know you when I pass you are safe to society or unsafe to society. Still in Indian scenario, the urological education and exam pattern is limited to that one. So you should
totally agree with sir.
Yeah. You should be very, very, you should talk like a consultant without arrogance.
Good suggestion. Dr. Gita has taken many, many exams. So, and he was co-examiner with many, many other examiners. So, he knows everyone's pulse. So, just listen to him what he is telling and appear for your exams. And all the best to all of you. I'm sure all of you will pass. 100%.
Good luck to all of you. And our best wishes and blessings are with you. Sure, you will shine.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. All of you are well prepared. Just be cool, calm, be simple. Do answer what you're saying, what you're doing. That's it.
Just a suggestion.
If you are not remembering anything, just remember your teacher, what he has done in that particular situation. 99% time, percent time, that is correct.
Correct, sir.
Just a small suggestion. Hello.
Yeah. That's
yeah,
I would.
Please,
carry your logbooks with you. If at all DNB has told not to carry, just whatever you have made the logbook, carry it for a safer side. Because end time some examiners may ask or may not.
Actually, usually it is seen. Last time also we have seen the logbook.
No, some centers they do not see. Therefore, to all students, just carry the logbooks and. Just be precise in answering. OSCE 150 marks all are in your hand actually. The maximum you score in OSCE, the maximum you will go through the examination. That is important, I think.
Yes, because OSCE is common. Means, I agree with you. You are not facing any examiner. You are just answering. So, if you are very precise in your answering and if you can finish your questions, you are through. Out of 150, if you get 120 marks, finish. Out of 300, you have to get only another 30-40 marks. Good.
Correct.
All the best to students.
All the best.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Good luck to everybody.
Bye-bye.